Okay.
That means we're paying off 50% of your debt.
Oh my God.
Plus what you won in the first couple rounds. That brings you up to $24,211.
They make paying off your student loans look fun. But you and I, we know better.
What's happening here?
We've been after you for years.
Who are you?
Student loans.
No.
You're coming with us.
Paying them off can take years. Longer than most wars, presidential terms, or celebrity marriages. The total U.S. student loan debt, are you ready for this? It's $1.4 trillion, according to Student Loan Hero. That's split among about 44 million people. And while graduates are emptying their pockets trying to dig themselves out of debt, it's actually their parents who are sinking, trying to help them out. The New York Times appropriately calls the data by savingforcollege.com a shifting burden. Students' debt on average has been consistently higher than their parents' contributions until recently. Around 2014, it switched, and the gap is only widening. Parents are going deeper into debt to pay for their kids to go to college. The National Center for Education says in 2016, undergrad students took out, on average, about $7,600 in total student loans. Meanwhile, their parents took out double that in federal parent loans. That's $14,000. But for now, most parents have shown they're still willing to help their kids out. SavingForCollege.com helps parents choose the best way to pay for their kids' education. It asked parents how they felt about this responsibility. 60% of them have hopes they'll be able to cover at least 75% of their kids' tuition. But only 40% are confident they can pay for their child's top school. As a result, 59% are willing to send their kids to a public school, child's preference or not, to cut costs. Now, usually I try to sneak in some good news right about here, but sadly there doesn't seem to be any for generous parents moving forward. 72% of them report they no longer carry their own student loan debt, but that's changing. SavingForCollege.com says 36% of parents, 25 to 34, are carrying $10,000 or more in student loans. So the site believes eventually parents will be trying to figure out how to balance not only their own debt, but their kids' debt too. It definitely makes you worry about whether the cycle will ever end. VP of research at SaferCollege.com, Mark Kantrowitz, tells Newsy more people are trying to avoid four-year universities altogether. He said data shows more students are getting associate's degrees or choosing certificate programs because it's what their family can afford. He says that kind of financial pressure is concerning. And I don't know about you, but I just heard about 44 million Americans say, tell me about it.
As an architecture major, if you could build a structure that would represent your student debt, what would it be?
It'd be a giant middle finger.